Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I am going to dig into the new card visual, although it's been around for a little while, so we'll just say the card visual as it is. But before we get into all of that, be sure to hit that like button, smash it if you so desire, and if it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, there was the original card visual that was just like a single value, and then they came out with this KPI visual that'll let you do a little bit more, but now we've got, it's called the new card visual, but I'm just gonna call it the card visual, and this one allows you to do a lot. Get prepared for a lot of tinkering and a lot of clicks to get it to look the way you want it. So enough all this talking, you know, we like to do it here in Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my machine. All right, so I've got a canvas here and you'll see this visual here is the KPI visual. So if we look at that, that's the KPI. And then we've got that old card visual that was there that just, yeah, I'm just going to ignore that one. So what I'm going to do is come down to this new card visual. So this is a preview feature as of the recording of this video. So be sure you've enabled that preview feature if you don't see this. So I'm going to go ahead and hit that visual, get it on the canvas. And first off, we need to add some data. What do we want? So I'm just going to pull in regular sales amount. Let's drag that in and bam, there you go. This is where the tinkering needs to come in, right? We need to do a lot of work here to get it to look the way we want. So hang in with me, we'll get there. Now, one thing that's also cool about the new card visuals, you can actually have multiple cards within this as like a series. So like I could do this and it'll add items and you can just add a whole bunch of things. So now it's one visual. And so this actually helps with performance in terms of limiting the number of visuals. And I love that. But let's just stick with sales amount and we'll go from there. So first off, let's just resize this a little bit. You can play around with this, obviously, like beyond what I'm doing here. And let's just go down and see what we got. So if we go to size and position, right, this looks okay. Come down, you can play around with those if you want. For padding, let's fix this up a little bit. We'll do 15. I'm gonna add a little bit more space in here to get a little more padding around the side. So that's just adding this extra outside padding, right? For background, let's just go and add a light theme to it. And then we'll do transparency 66. That makes it even lighter, which is cool. And we'll come down to visual border. We'll say, yep. And we'll pick that same color we did before. And then we'll do rounded quarters, 25, and then a width of 1 is fine as well. So now we've got some rounded quarters on the edge. We're working on the outside, working our way in. And then let's add a shadow. You shouldn't use shadows at all. I've heard that from so many people. But if you just turn it on, yes, it's aggressive. But let me change the values a little bit, and then you be the judge of where it is now versus after I change it. You know, you got this dark border here, so let's change this to this color here. Wow, that looks so much better, Adam. No, it doesn't. So let's go to custom and let's play around with this a little bit. Now, look at that. It's very subtle. It's very nice. It's just a little touch of a shadow. It just separates it a little bit more. I agree with the default shadows. Eh, it's a little bit much, but when you tinker with it, you can get it looking nice. All right, moving on down. So size and style, we're done with that. Titles. So between our title and subtitle, we can add some more info here just to make it useful to give people a indication of what's going on. All right, layout, single row is good. Cards auto, that's fine. Nothing needs to change there. So the callout value is going to be this white area. So this is the main area. And so you can do items for everything or you can do items individually. So right now we're just gonna tinker for this one card. Let's come down, we'll say, we'll bring the font down a little bit. We'll say bold, all of that looks okay. Come to the label, see here. So we want to say below the value so you can change where it is. Let's change the font, change it to bold, make it 11, make it a little smaller, and we can change the name. And then we'll also adjust the space between just to get it to look a little tighter. All right, and then layout, we're gonna move that to the top. And then this callout size, we'll come back to that after we do some more adjustments. Already, it's starting to take its shape and form. It's not as just bland and dull as it was when we first started. So it's getting exciting. More tinkering to come. Let's go. So this reference label for the given sales amount. So again, I can do it for everything, or I can say, hey, just for the sales amount one. Typically, this is going to be specific to the value that's being displayed in the card in the individual callout. In this case, I want to see sales for the previous year. And so I'll drag that in, and then you'll see that we've got some more information here, which is good. And then again, you can do this for all of the items, or you can do it for a specific item that you've declared. So you could have multiple labels here. So we're gonna be doing this first against everything, And so if we come down to background, we'll come down to this color. We've changed this item. So when it says reference labels, that's going to be this area here. And then the top white part is going to be the call out. So we do want to make some changes here. So we'll do 10 and we'll change this to a lighter color. We'll make it even lighter or a little shaded differently. Come down to value. All right, and then let's change this to the specific value. We'll do a few more things here. We'll title, we'll give it a custom name. Let's just call it previous year. So that's a more friendly name. Values are good. And then for the details, what I want to do here is I want to say percent change. It's going to add some more information here. We got to change this up a little bit. 10 font color, we'll do white. And then for color, make it a little green. You can play around with the fonts to see which one you like. I'll just leave it as that. And then again, just tinkering, figuring out what you like, what your colors are. You can do conditional formatting on these items. All right, so most of that is good. Let's add an image in there as well. So we'll do image. Got a predefined image here. We'll do that. We'll say below text. So now it's kind of here. We'll add a little bit more spacing. And then we can come down to the final settings of the layout here. And so the shape will say rounded rectangles and we'll just say 19. That looks good. So now we're rounded on there. And then padding wise, we'll do custom, do 30, 40. We'll leave that one 4 and 50. So now we've got a little more spacing inside the items, which is good. So alignment is fine. Turn off the border, we'll turn on a shadow. And again, we'll tinker a little bit more. Do custom is 0. It's very subtle again, but it is there. One thing I forgot on the reference labels, let's go back and we'll say all, we'll come down to layout. And we'll say columns. So now it's there. And then we'll do center. And then you can decide if you want it top aligned or middle aligned, whatever. So you can see the difference here. The spacing gets a little weird. So I'll just do top alignment there. That looks good. And then this is like the final tweaking. You've got the main elements there. So now you're just trying to get the sizing right and just making it fit and finish. And so that's what we're doing right now. All right. So values will come here. Let's maybe, what if we bring it down one more? No, 38. All right. That looks good. That fit. And then one thing I said we were going to come back to is this callout size. This gets enabled once you set the reference label information. And so we can play with this. A bigger number means this will be smaller. And so we can just kind of, oh, that's too much. So what if we do 55? And then we could bring that down a little bit and then make it even smaller, 65. Bam, there you go. This could be a final state for you, but take a look at where we were in the beginning. So if we come back and we just look at what we had, night and day. Yeah, I mean, this looks pretty good. We could ship that. It looks delightful. So the new card visual allows you to actually do a lot of tinkering to the point where you can make it look really nice and align to whatever your business standards are, or what, you know, custom themings for your organization and whatnot. All right, I'd love to know your thoughts. Have you played around with the new card visual? Do you love it? Are you doing banana things with it? I'd love to know. Let me know in the comments below. And let's keep that conversation going. If you look over my head, there'll be another video for you. So definitely go check that out and learn all the cool things. And as always, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome. And we'll see you in the next video.